Aussies love a good barbie. It's such a huge part of our culture, isn't it, Joe? But according to our next guest, Chef Lennox Hastie, the best tasting food is cooked on a fire that is fueled by wood. Lennox, welcome to the show. Great
Thank
to have you.
Thank you very much. Great to be here.
Got to go. You're cooking with gas, wood this morning.
That's the whole point.
We are famous for our barbies, but we've been doing it wrong by cooking with gas, right?
Most indeed. I mean, there's different ways of cooking with fire. Yeah. And obviously gas is what we get represented most every day. But if you go back 200 years, literally everyone's cooking with wood.
All right. So how do you get it actually started? Joe, you're looking at it like you're a pyromaniac.
Oh, I just love it so much.
Entranced by the flames.
Well, I'll tell you the truth. When we were growing up, because I grew up very poor, very poor, but our barbecue in the backyard was actually just a wood barbecue. It was basically just a sheet of cast iron on a few bricks.
Fantastic.
And stuck the wood under
Excellent.
It.
So you already have those early memories.
Oh, I've got them all. That's right. That's how I became a pyromaniac.
So how do you build a fire then?
Well, there's lots of different ways you can actually establish a fire, and it's relatively straightforward.
Yep.
But obviously the thing we're looking at here is the wood itself. So the fact we're burning wood, and it's Australian hardwood. Like these are hardwoods. This is iron bark here we're using as a base, which is a member of the eucalypt family, one of the densest hardwoods within Australia, actually within the world.
Right.
Quite amazing. The quality of the wood, that long, slow burn. And then establishing the fire, like there's lots of different sort of formations.
Yeah, the way you've stacked it looks
Yeah, some people like a TP method.
Yeah, I like a TP.
This is called what they call a log cabin.
Yep.
As you can tell by the way it's structured, it's sort of like crisscrossing of different woods.
Because interestingly, I grew up in a log cabin, which I built with my own bare hands.
But hopefully you didn't. Hands indeed.
This is fantastic. And you also have a book called Finding Fire, which I believe is the next installment in the Hunger Games. tell us a bit about that.
So the book essentially gives you a great overview of how cooking with fire can be embraced. Mm. And I want people to really embrace it, you know, in their backyards.
Is this part of that whole sort of paleo, let's all go back to being cavemen sort of
Not at thing? All. It's just going back to what really means something. I mean, fire's where we all began.
Remembers flying this way.
Oh, yes.
Watch the face. I've got a question. If you're cooking with a specific kind of wood, that obviously affects the flavour of the food, right?
Correct. Yeah.
Did I say that you were cooking with some apple wood or something?
Yeah, true. So each wood within the hardwood family has its own characteristics depending on the temperature or also the flavour profile. So whereas you got iron bark here, you know,
And what sort of flavour does that give the food?
Iron bark's more of the heat propensity.
Right,
so it's more of that high temperature range. It's quite a neutral in flavour profile.
Yep.
And then you can mix in different woods, like for instance, this is cherry wood, orange, gnarly grapevines, plum.
So that orange wood, would it actually give a citrusy sort of taste?
It does have some essential sort of citrus bases through it. I mean, there's more sort of imparted throughout its leaves, but it's more to find something that's going to enhance the natural beauty of the ingredient.
And is it true that you did this just to avoid higher power prices?
I don't know. It's quite labour intensive when in terms of cutting wood.
Yeah, right. Because you've just got one electricity outlet in your restaurant, is that right?
Pretty much, yeah, exactly. Everything we do in terms of cooking is all based on fire. So it's across the board, the entire menu, and everything over wood.
Now, we're going to check back in with you in about an hour and a half.
Fantastic.
Is that right?
Excellent.
And see how you're going with cooking with fire.
I look forward to it.
Lennox, we'll see you soon. Thank you very much for
that.
We're cooking pipis. So stay tuned for that next. All right, well, earlier in the show, Chef Lennox Hastie showed us how to light a barbecue fire because it's all about cooking with actual fire.
It gives wood.
Food actual better fire. Taste,
wood.
Right? Yes. So you've been working on the fire, getting it going, burning away for the last hour and a half. How do you know that it's right for cooking?
So it's all part of the process, allowing the wood time to burn down to that ember stage.
Yes.
As you see now, it's burnt down. There's not a lot.
Big flames.
That's what subsided.
Yep.
And what you're left with are these beautiful embers, which then you have the most biggest expression of heat. Because what you want to be cooking over is not flames, but embers themselves.
All right. And we're cooking pipis today as well.
Pipis.
This has long been a bit of a bait, used as bait. Pipis,
a little bit.
Right?
Certainly when I was young, typically sort of pipi shuffling on the beach.
Yeah.
And typically you'd grab a pipi, put it on your hook.
Oh, look,
throw it in the sea.
Coming out. Look, it's coming out.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Didn't you just say, am I going crazy?
We can't use that one. We should throw him back in the ocean.
Because I used to love collecting all the pippies for myself, but then my mum said I was just being shellfish.
Wow, that's good. All right, so where do we start?
Sorry, can you see? Look, it's coming out. Look, now it's going back. My God.
Well, we can't put that one on there. That's
reminds
a bit
me
mean.
Of my first date.
Are these alive?
They are, correct. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh. Okay, let's just forget we said that, kids.
They're dead,
they're happy.
All right,
they're,
so what do we do?
They're vegetables.
So super simple. Pippies, meat grill, And the great thing about Pipis is that essentially they're their own cooking vessel.
Of course.
They come in their own little fry pan.
You don't need to flavour them or anything, you just
not at all.
Them on the fire.
All the flavour comes from the heat and the flavour comes from the wood itself.
Okay. Ooh, and how long does it take?
Literally a couple of minutes.
Yeah, right.
Oh, the heat fantastic. And they pop open.
And what do you serve with a Pipi?
Super simple. We serve some garlic shoots and some Karkalla.
Is that native or is that?
So this is native. It's a sea succulent. They call it Karkalla, or in Australia, they call it beach bananas.
Beach bananas.
Grows on the beach.
No, I love.
Yeah. Beach
looks
bananas.
Like a banana.
I love the beach and I love bananas.
So you see the Pipis are popping already.
Yep.
Yeah.
And tell us again. We were talking earlier about your restaurant where you managed to run the whole thing with just one power outlet. Is that right? Just one electrical plug?
Correct. We have lighting. We have power, but in the form of cooking, it's all with wood.
So it's nothing.
And all
so
with fire. As you see here, this is what we do in the restaurant every day.
That's amazing.
You see how quick and easy it is? They just pop open.
Well, they've already opened now.
Gee, that was really quick. How's your little friend?
Well, I think he's gone back inside. I think he knows what's coming.
Okay.
And then how many people would this sort of
feed?
Is this an entree? Is it an entree or is it a?
It could be an entree. It could be more of a main course if you mix it through with some pasta or something.
Yes, that would be nice, wouldn't it?
Like the classic Italian vongole.
Ah, yes, the vongole.
Now you've got some garlic and a bit of
Look
at a bit of a Joe Hildebrand fan club here.
Hi guys, how are you?
Bit of garlic and also chili.
Yes, correct. Yeah. A little bit of garlic, a little bit of chili. And I'm going to ask if you could cut the lemon cheek there.
Oh yes, I'd love to.
Do you know how to do that?
Fresh lemon.
Sorry, I'm just on television at the moment, but we'll be with you in a second. So how do we cut the? How do we cut the lemon? How
just
do you...
take the cheeks.
What are the cheeks?
If you look at it, look at the cheek like as a triangle.
Is the lemon alive as well?
Yeah, so you look at it as a triangle.
Yeah.
And you go for a cheek.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So is that a cheek there?
And then we just remove the seeds.
Sorry, I'm not very good in there.
It's okay.
Joe's very passionate about food.
Very passionate.
He's a real foodie.
Passionate. Yeah, I'm a...
We'll take some lemon zest as well over here.
He has a very fast metabolism as well,
I have
well,
a very fast
Joe.
Metabolism.
You should ask him about it sometime.
I use food to eat, to keep me alive.
Because he's flavouring that with a bit of lemon zest in there as well.
A bit of zest. So the reason the essential oils, so we have the oils from the lemon itself.
Yep.
Wow.
And the juice.
And where do you get Pipis from? Do you just get them from
you can get them in the fish market.
Yep.
It's really important that they've been purged.
What does that mean?
Essentially, so they've been rinsed through a water cycle.
Right,
there's nothing, obviously, where they live in the sand.
Yes.
They have a tendency to be quite gritty by their nature. They're a filter.
Oh,
so
okay.
It's essentially they're purged.
Because other shovers, you want to keep the sea flavour, don't you? But with Pipis, you want to get...
Well, you get all that sea flavour. They're purged in a saltwater tank. So you get all that flavour of the sea, all those juices.
Right.
They're mixed with the lemon.
Gosh, it does smell good. Oh, wow.
And when you're cooking with wood, where do you actually get the wood from to start the fire?
So we work a lot with our... local friends, which are friends of our suppliers, our producers, because a lot of them have orchards. They're also recognised suppliers throughout New South Wales.
So if I was just wanting to cook something on a wood fire at home, where would I go? Would I, you know, can I just use any wood that's like we can pick up at Bunnings or?
Best to sort of the quality of the wood. Good question.
Yeah.
Quality is super important.
Yeah.
In terms of the fact that it's hardwood, Australian hardwoods, but also being naturally seasoned for at least 2 years.
Whoa. Oh, 2 years.
You season the wood as well.
It's quite a process.
That's amazing.
Wow.
Just pass me that olive oil.
Yes, of course.
Okay, fantastic.
Thank you very much.
This is olive oil? Yep.
Yep.
Right.
And the parsley, please.
That's amazing. And are there any woods that you should avoid? Like, obviously, shouldn't be burning treated pine. And
anything that's treated, any of those sort of offcuts of like old fence posts or. You know, anything like an old railway sort of sleeper, things like that, you shouldn't burn.
I shouldn't cook with that.
Because essentially, you're not just looking at heat source, but also a flavour impartment on the food.
Yeah, right.
That's why we burn a lot, especially with... So today we're burning... we use a base of iron bark and then burnt through some apple wood.
That is amazing. So the wood actually gives the food flavour.
This looks brilliant. We are going to keep cooking, but when we come back, we've got a bit of a crowd here. Check them out. They've all come to taste the food.
And also for me
Hey, guys. Listen, we are going to take a very quick break, but when we come back, we are tasting these Pipis. It smells phenomenal. You are watching Studio 10. Don't go anywhere. Our Pipis have been pipped on an open fire. What's this? Is this butter and garlic?
Not at all. It's just the juices from the pippies.
Oh, wow.
Olive oil juice. And some lemon juice.
Oh, yeah.
We have actually drawn a bit of a crowd here. Check this out.
That's right.
These people have smelt the food. That's they right. know Joe Hildebrand's out of here. Actually, they're here for the Family Feud record.
No, they thought they were here for me.
But I think we should taste these.
Oh, yeah, these.
Incredible.
I'm not able to.
Most certainly.
This has all been cooked on Australian hardwood. Yeah. Right. That's incredible.
And we just dig in.
Dig in.
Come on,
and you could
Todd.
Serve this Go. With pasta as well. Wait. I love this lemon.
Oh, yum. They're beautiful.
Todd, can I just ask you a personal really question?
Yeah, what?
Have you got wood?
No, but no, you do.
There you go.
Well, I was Australian wood.
You buy me a drink first.
you should definitely buy Lennox Hastie's book if you want
yeah,
it.
Yes. Finding Fire.